Hello and welcome to our course on IK Multimedia's T-Rex 5. I'm Rory from Hyper Production and you are with us here at Sonic Academy. So if you've watched the previous videos in this course, you should have a bit of an understanding as to what basically T-Rex is and where certain areas are and what they mean, i.e. the meters and where to find certain bits and bobs like that. So we've already spoken about the individual modules that you can use within your DAW to more focus on the mixing elements, but now we're going to look at the standalone version and talk about the plugin as a mastering suite. Then we're going to look at importing the audio, adding some modules, and then we'll touch upon a basic bit of mastering as well to try and get you up to the results of where we are as well. Now, the track files will be involved, basically included into this course, so you will be able to download them and use them, basically follow step by step what we're doing here. Now, you might just see straight away that we've got master match up here. Don't worry about that for now. I will be covering that on a whole video further on in this course. So what we need to focus on now is how to actually get some audio in, get some audio playing, start hearing stuff, and then focus on how to add certain modules within our chain. Now, there's a couple of ways that you can add audio here. You can either go up to File and then go to Import Audio, or you can hold down Command and press I for import, and that could do it that way, or you can click this little plus button down here, which will then import your audio into the clip list arrange view. So it's just quickly analysed the track and then it's ready to go. So if I start playing that now, then it's going to start playing there. We've got all our meters going. So it might be worthwhile, instead of just adding loads of stuff on and, you know, or selecting a preset, just have a little listen to what your pre-master is actually doing at the moment. So if we basically press play, okay, so we're hitting a peak of around -9.5 decibels. We're about +1 on the loudness meter, and the spectral analyzer is showing that we're quite mono. So we could definitely do some stuff to enhance the sound of that overall track. We can make it a bit wider and make it a bit louder and possibly draw out some of the punchiness within that track as well. But just so you're aware, this course is not necessarily about how to master, because that is a beast of a course all on its own. So I will be showing you purely just focused on how to use T-Rex 5. So we've got our track in there. We want to start adding some bits into our chain. So typically when you first open up T-Rex 5, you will normally have this mastering processor here, otherwise known as One. Now, it's called One because it's pretty much an all-in-one encompassing mastering plugin. If you're looking to just do a quick master for a track that you wish to play out the weekend and it's just got to sound good and nice and loud and punchy, and you want to get to that point quite quickly, this plugin is for you. So let's go over a few of the details and what this includes, and then I'll be showing you some basically demonstrations of what each individual parameter sounds like on this track that we've got loaded in. So focus, this one here, tends to lean more towards basically bumping up sort of the high mids to give that bit of presence and a bit more focus, if you like, to the track, just to make it seem a bit more in your face. Air basically relates to the high-end sheen that you normally find on a lot of sort of commercially released tracks. It adds that nice bit of shimmer and sort of bit of a high-end boost to make it seem a little bit more clear and bring out the clarity. The body focuses more focuses on the lower end, sort of low mids to high lows sort of thing, and that will give you a bit more boominess, a bit more boxiness. So if you've got a particularly sort of tinny mix, then that is definitely sort of the thing that you want to be boosting. But likewise, if you've got something that sounds a bit muddy, definitely just dial back on the body parameter there, and it should help clear up the muddiness of your mix. Now the push, that's going to be pushing it right up into the limiter. That's where your compression is going to start being more apparent. It's going to start squashing the dynamics a little bit and just start pushing it and making it seem a bit more energetic, if you like. That's probably the best term to use. Width, that's quite self-explanatory, just sort of pushes out a lot of the stuff that's already panned within the track. Just pushes them out just that little bit further to give you a nice wide stereo sort of impactful, epic sort of sounding, so obviously you can mix that to taste of however you want. Volume is just basically boosting up the volume of the track to get you to that point. But the difference between push and volume is that push will then be pushing into the limiter, whereas the volume is just purely boosting the track. So if you have push down and boost up the volume, you will start hearing distortion. But if you try and dial in both of them sort of in conjunction with each other and try and find that sweet spot, you will get a nice, lovely sort of brick wall limiter top effect without any distortion. We've also got a reset button here, which basically just resets all the parameters. So if you don't like what you're doing, you want to start all over again, just hit that reset button and that will take you back to the beginning. Bypass, self-explanatory, flick that on and off to switch off bypass. Each individual module will have a bypass button, and that's obviously just in case you don't like something or you don't know how beneficial that particular module that you're adding is going to be. You can sort of bypass it really quickly there as well. There's many different ways you can sort of reference a lot of different stuff. Obviously, you've got the ABCD reference, you've got the global bypass, and you've got bypassing individual modules as well, which is super handy. We've got transients here, which is basically just going to sharpen a lot of transients, make your track sound a little bit more punchy. Again, use carefully because sometimes you can end up sort of really crushing the dynamics of some transients and it can kind of ruin the dynamics a little bit. But certainly in house music, can get that kick drum out, it can really make it nice and punchy, and yeah, that's definitely one worth dialing into. Analog, basically any plugin that's got an analog sort of function on it is going to add sort of a very quiet low hum, if you like. So when I play the track through, you'll notice on the spectral analyzer here that it's going to start sort of filling out a little bit more. This is because it's adding sort of a bed of noise, and that's what gives you that sort of analog warmth, that sort of vinyl warmth, if you like. Imagine sort of the crackling of a needle on a turntable. That's sort of going to add that sort of vibe to it. Bass punch, again, pretty self-explanatory. Bass punch and body are quite similar, so if you just want a little bit more low-end punch in there, by all means dial up that bass punch as well. So I'm just going to play it now. I'm going to bypass it off. I'm going to start playing the track, and then I'm going to basically introduce it. And you'll notice what a difference it actually makes. And it's surprising for one module to make such a difference. So here we go. Okay, so you can hear this making quite a bit of difference. Like the low end has certainly been brought out a little bit more, and the transients have been made to be a little bit more punchy, which is great. But there's certainly some more room for improvement that we can do there as well. Now, what you will notice is that the level went up. The whole point of mastering, we don't necessarily want to be increasing the volume sort of this early on when you're doing masters. That the volume addition can happen a little bit later. But I mean, fundamentally, a lot of the volume or high, the loudness comes from the mixing. But what you don't want to do is just believe that because something's louder, you know, that means it sounds better. So that's when this gain, sort of match gain toggle up here begins to make sense, because then we can actually hear the processing that's happening, how the dynamics are fixing, how the EQ is then affecting the overall sound and the shape of our track. So what I'm going to do is actually bypass it. Then I'm going to switch it on, and then I'm going to put match gain output on, and you'll see exactly what I mean. Okay, so that is the best way of how you can make sure that you're not just purely adding volume. So use this gain, match gain output toggle to really make sure that your processing is actually benefiting the track. It's a real powerful way to make sure that your masters are going to be of the best to your ability and to their ability. So maybe we don't want just an all-in-one processing plugin. Maybe we want to actually create like a proper chain, which is what this is all about. You know, this is how we can start honing our skills and start practicing how to do some really high quality industry ready masters. So let's just get rid of that one for now. Now what the first we want to do is probably just add maybe a little high-end sheen. So I think the best plugin for this is going to be the EQP1A, which is based heavily on the old TubeTech equalizers. So what we want to do is start adding some and also taking away some frequencies as well. So let's have a listen. We'll be right back.
Hello, what's up? I called to say I got your message and yeah, I've been great. They say it don't rain in LA. Well, I was drowning, but now I'm okay. Took a couple weeks to surface. Let me tell you about that champagne you say.
Okay, so we like that little bit of support on the low end there, and also adding a little high-end sheen as well. Now, these individual plugins are heavily referenced and based on sort of real-life analog gear, so it might be worth just sort of Googling quickly about what each individual one means and what they're good for and what they're used for, because each individual one has its own benefits for various different things. So this is always my personal go-to one in terms of adding a little bit of air and sort of having a bit of low end added into there. I think it's really warm, it's really nice. The algorithms that they use for the TubeTech EQs are just unreal, and they sound lovely as well and really musical, and they don't sort of boost anything sort of synthetically. It always sounds very natural. And then you've got the attenuation here, which is basically just honing in the Q-tip onto whatever frequency you choose. So this is your frequency here, so low frequency or high frequency there, going from 3k to 16k, and this is obviously going from 20 hertz to 100 hertz, and then the boost is quite self-explanatory. So then what we're going to do is maybe add an EQ. So we've got a Equal plug in here just so we can visually see what's actually going on. So I'm going to play that through. So you can already see we've got a little dip around here, so we're going to boost that mid slightly. We've got a little bit too much probably going on the high end, so let's just reduce that slightly. Okay, so we're more or less getting towards our sort of final master. So let's have a little look at maybe adding a compressor. So we've got an opto compressor here, and then let's have a little play around with that. Now, again, you'll notice that I turned the output down. We don't necessarily want to be adding any volume. We just want to process the signal as it is. So that's why I've turned down the output. Now, a sweet spot between mastering compression, I find, is normally between, you know, a ratio of 3:1. So you only want to be about sort of 3 decibels worth of gain reduction, because then you can bring it all up with the sort of brick wall limiter at the end. And if you need to do any, or if you need to be a bit harsh on the compression to try and rein in some more of those dynamics, that's fine. But you want to try and be as transparent as you can. So there we have sort of a basic chain of our mastering. And this is, you know, you can add as many modules as you want. Definitely try out all the different modules as we're going along. Even add some like reverbs in there, which you can put into the chain, and you can sort of do parallel chain as well rather than just serial. What I mean by that is serial. This is a serial chain that we've got here, so it's one after the other. And you could do parallel chaining as well, which is basically where you just insert another module in conjunction, coinciding, parallel. I don't know if there's any more words to describe. With maybe like an EQ here, or that EQ, or that compressor. They just run totally alongside them. So they're really powerful ways of gaining a really good master as well. So definitely have a play around with it. Make so many different mastering chains. Well, 4, I suppose, would probably be a good one to start off with. And then just reference them. So if I click on that, you'll notice that they all go back to that single mastering processor there. So and then on A, we've got this one. But if you want to copy these, you just simply click copy, and then we go on to B, and then you'll notice that it's already copied onto our reference B channel there as well. So I've been Rory from Hyper Production, and you've been watching Sonic Academy. Stay tuned.